10 common array methods. I'm going to go over some of the most commonly used array methods in JavaScript. The first one is going to be array is push, the push method. This just adds a new element to the end of an array. And if I console.log that, you can see now it's A, B, C, D. And you can see that it started off as just A, B, C. The next one I want to show you is pop. Pop removes the last element in an array and returns that element. If I run that, we're going to see that we have the D. And then if I just console.log the array again, you will see that now the array doesn't have that the D on there because it's been popped off. The push and pop changes the original array. Now the next one is concat, which concatenates two arrays. First I have to make a new array. So I have the first array, concat array 2. If I run that, we're going to see A, B, C, G, Q. One thing interesting about that is that it does not affect the original array. So if I just console.log the second array, we'll see that it's still G, Q. The next one I'm going to go over is join. This joins all the elements in an array to create a string and also does not modify the original array. So if we run that, you can see at the end we just have the string ABC. And if we put something, I join this with just an empty string, but I can also put something in here like an exclamation point. I can run that, and you can see now there's an exclamation point between each item in the array and that string. And the original array stays the same. Next up is reverse, which just reverses the elements in an array. And if I run that, you can see at the bottom, CBA. And that does change the array. So if I console.log the array now, you can see at the end CBA, CBA. The shift function is going to remove the first element in the array and return that element. So the first element is C because we reversed it. Remember, before we reversed that array to CBA, now it's returning that first element C, and if we just console.log that array again, we will see that it is the C is removed. So if you look at the bottom, it's just going to be BA for the array. Unshift adds a new element to the beginning of the array and returns the length of the modified array. So at the end, it's just going to say 3, because remember, before the array was BA, so this has added the P to the end to make 3 elements in the array. So if we just log that array, we'll see PBA, add the P at the beginning of the array. Slice is going to select part of an array and return that new array that you've selected, and the original array remains unchanged. Slice is going to accept two arguments, the start and the n minus 1. Let me give you an example. So it's going to start at the index 1, and then the second argument is the end minus 1. 2 minus 1 is going to be 1. So this is only going to be one character of the array, because it's this minus 1 for the end character. Let me console.log that so you can see that. This is the original array, PBA. And we're going to start at index 1, starts at index 0, then we have index 1, and then we're going to end at the index 2 minus 1, 0, 1, 2 minus 1. So we're going to end at the same character that we started at. So it's only going to return B. If we change the second argument to 3, then it's going to be BA instead of A. And slice does not change the original array. So the original array is still going to be PBA. Now I'm going to show you sort, which just sorts an array. So first, I'm going to push a few more letters onto the array. If you see at the end, A, B, F, I, P. So that's all sorted, even though you can see that I added F at the end, it ended up sorting. And remember, first it was P, B, A. This is what the array started off as, because this, when it slices something, it's not going to change the original array. So we had this, and we added if, and then it sorted to be like that. And you can see that sort does change the original array. The last one I'm going to tell you about is splice. Splice is very similar to slice, but it's going to modify the original array instead of just returning a new array. Also, the arguments are going to be a little different. The first argument is going to be the start index. We'll set it as 2. The second argument is the number of items to count from the starting point to remove. So if I put 2, that means 2 items are going to be removed starting at the second index. If I put 3, then 3 items will be removed. And then the third argument is any items you want to add. So I'm going to add JS nuggets. And it's going to return the items that were removed. And then I'm going to log the array. So if you can see, first it removes fi, because it started off with this array. And we went to the index 2, we have 0, 1, 2, we remove 2 items, 1, 2, f and I, and that's what it returns for this first console.log. And then we're going to console.log the new array, which is b, js nuggets, because it's going to insert it at the index that we had up here, which is the second index, and we're still going to have the p on here. Well, thanks for watching. My name is Beau Carnes. Don't forget to subscribe, and remember, use your code for good.